Good morning, or it's morning my time. I'm not sure what time it is your time. But today we are going to be looking again at similarity between two polygons. But today we're going to be focusing on the proof of similarity. Now, we are going to be looking at flowchart proofs today. So your objective today is you will learn how to use flowcharts to organize your arguments for triangle similarity and continue to practice applying the similarity conditions from the last lesson. Now, flowcharts are very precise. You must precisely label the side lengths, the angle measures, and you must precisely say what conditions and mathematics is used to show the statements in your proof. So please today, use the habit of mind where you are focusing on accuracy and precision. Well, now that you have looked at problem 59, to kind of get you warmed up getting going, we are going to do an example together of a flowchart proof. So we are given two triangles. We are given this triangle and we're given this triangle. So let's label the triangles so that we have the corresponding sides and angles. Triangle CDF. How would I label this triangle so that its sides are proportional? Well, we can see that angle R is congruent to angle C, so we can start with R, and then we went from C to D, which is the long side, so we can go R, T, Q. Okay, now looking at the given triangles, I notice I have an angle congruent, and then I notice I'm given two lengths. So I'm hoping, well, maybe side angle side will work, because the angle given is between the two given sides. So in a flowchart proof, we always start with the given information. So I want to prove proportionality of the sides. So I'm going to start with the given lengths of sides. And so we are given 12 over 3. That ratio is 4. So notice I usually will write the fact down and then circle it. Don't make your circles first because you don't know how big you need them. Now I'm going to look at the ratio of the other two given sides. And that would be 8 to 2, which has a ratio also of 4. Since those ratios are equal, I now know that those lengths are proportional. So I can use this fact and this fact to say, so we went from 12 to 3, so we went R, T to C, D. That ratio is equal to the ratio of 8 2. So 8, 2, we could go R, Q, 2, C, F. Okay? Now notice this proportion is equal, so we have just shown that two sides are proportional. Notice also when I label them, see how it's R, T? So in the triangle, R, T, and then C, D. Notice the order, C, D. R, Q, first, last, CF, first left. Also, so now we have proven two sides proportional. Now the angle between those two, we can notice is C for this CDF and is R for RTQ. And we are given that fact that the measurement of angle DCF is congruent to the measurement of angle TRQ. And that is also a given fact. Now, having these two facts, I now can state the similarity of the two triangles. Triangle CDF is similar to triangle RTQ. We put a circle around it. And how am I allowed to say that? By the similarity condition of side angle side. Fantastic. So you can see everything is done in a very orderly way. I used two facts to show proportionality. Notice the arrows going down to that one fact. And then this fact, now with the other given fact, the two together, then show similarity. Now you are going to work on a few more. So task manager, get your group working now on problems 61 to 63. And then at the end of the class, we'll check 63 together. So now what you're going to do is you're going to check the proofs that you have for the last problem. Now I'd like you to take out a colored pen and make corrections to the work that you did in your group. So in this problem, I was given two triangles with a lot of facts, okay? We are given some angle measurements and some side lengths. Now I decided to use side angle side to prove similarity. Could you have used angle-angle? Yeah, you could have, okay? So in order for me to prove side-angle-side, first thing I have to know is that the sides, corresponding sides, are proportional. And so we can see that CA to PG, CA is 8 over 12, okay? And then AT to GI, AT is 4 over 6. Well, 8 over 12 can be reduced to 2/3. 4 over 6 can be reduced to 2/3. So therefore, those ratios are equal, and we have a pair of corresponding sides. Now, as far as angle measurements go, I was given 101.2 and 56.5. Now you notice in this triangle, I was given two sides also, but not the third. Well, I can find the third knowing that the triangle angle sum theorem. So to find the angle of PGI, I would go 180 degrees minus the two given, which ends up with 101.2 degrees. Now by doing that information, then that leads me to say that measurement of angle PGI is congruent to measurement of angle CAT. So now, actually, I was also given that these two angles are congruent. So either I could use these two facts and by angle-angle say that the two triangles are similar, or I can use my side pair of proportional sides and the angles congruent to use side-angle-side. Either one would be a great proof of these two triangles' similarity. And then the last one that you did was, again, you're given two triangles. Okay, we're given these two triangles. Now notice the numbers are quite large, and I just can't look at the ratios and say, oh yeah, 8 over 12 equals 4 over 6. I actually have to do some mathematical calculations. So that's what I do first. I look at the ratio of 126.6 to 295.4, and I get this ratio, and I get this ratio. So I see that the ratios are equal, so therefore the proportion is true. So now I label LN over AB is equal to RL over CA. And then the fact that I was given was that measurement of RLN is congruent to measurement CAB. So now I have two facts, and they are side, angle, side, to show similarity of the two triangles. I hope that this is making sense to you.